breaking news.
Within the hour, the driver of this damaged car is formally charged in the hit-and-run crash that left a Milwaukee officer fighting for his life tonight. 12 News travels to Chicago to uncover new details about how police tracked the suspect down. And tonight, we're getting our first look at that suspect.
He is Juan Alvarado. The 19-year-old Milwaukee man is now charged with first-degree reckless injury and first-degree recklessly endangering safety. Now, according to court documents just obtained by 12 News, an alert neighbor might have been the key to this whole case. He saw Alvarado the day at the garage with the damaged car. When he asked Alvarado what happened, Alvarado said he had been drunk for 2 days and didn't know. Right now, Alvarado is in the Cook County Jail in Chicago awaiting extradition to Wisconsin. And 12 News reporter Nick Bohr spent the day in Chicago uncovering new information about how Milwaukee police tracked that man down.
Officers from Officer Frank Vertoshnik's own district came here to Chicago Wednesday after getting information the suspect was heading to Mexico on a bus. They headed him off here.
This was the end of the line for the 19-year-old suspect Wednesday afternoon, a Chicago bus station bathroom where officers found him hiding. We've learned the suspect boarded a bus in Milwaukee bound for Mexico, and with the help of Chicago police, Milwaukee officers made the arrest. The case against Juan Alvarado started to build steam Wednesday when, acting on a tip, officers discovered the heavily damaged Chevy Malibu in a garage near 15th and Beecher. The damage and vehicle matched the description of the car that struck 37-year-old officer Frank Vertoshnik Christmas Day. And according to the search warrant obtained by 12 News today, police observed blood and hair on the shattered and broken windshield. As that suspect vehicle was towed to the state crime lab for evidence collection, police developed the information that their suspect had already boarded a bus in Milwaukee, headed for Chicago, and ultimately Mexico. But they stopped him here in Chicago, and he was arrested without incident. Late this afternoon, the district attorney's office charged Alvarado with first-degree reckless injury and first-degree recklessly endangering safety. We've also learned police aren't seeking any additional suspects. In Chicago, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.
Officer Vertoshnik remains in critical condition at Frederick Hospital, but we're told tonight his condition is improving. His family released a statement late this afternoon thanking the community for their support, especially fellow officers. The family goes on to say, "We believe that each man and woman in uniform would have said what Frank told us from his hospital bed. It's better that it happened to me than someone else." A public prayer vigil for the officer gets underway in about an hour at St. Josephat's Basilica at 6th and Lincoln.